Hey everybody, welcome back. XDefiant officially launched today, and admittedly, it is off to a rocky start. And I gotta be honest with you, I know that the reason they gave us that this game got delayed is because they wanted to work on the matchmaking, they wanted to make sure that the crossplay worked and all that good stuff, but I gotta admit, the stuff that's available in this game isn't much different than what we were already experiencing through the betas. Like, sure, now we have progression. We can actually rank up our characters. We have a battle pass that we're able to progress up to level 50. And there are challenges to work on, but not like we originally thought there would be. And I don't know if this is just due to it being the preseason, and then when season one rolls around, then it'll be a little bit different. But working on weapon camouflage patterns really isn't a thing, because there's only mastery camo that you can earn in the form of bronze camo at level 50, silver camo at level 75, and then gold at level 100. While I think this is pretty cool, I was kind of hoping that there would be headshot challenges or, you know, sliding challenges or crouch challenges, you know, something similar to other first-person shooters that feature a camouflage grind. That doesn't seem to really exist at the moment. Although there are major base and daily challenges that you can complete, currently right now through the base challenges, you're required to do specific things with specific categories of weapons to unlock the next weapon, and that gives you access to it. Same thing with devices and faction characters. The more that you do in game with a specific faction, and depending on how you use that faction, you will unlock another character for it. And unlocking these characters is as simple as getting a set amount of kills or assists or doing something similar with the abilities within the faction. So it won't take too long to actually unlock these things. Daily challenges are going to reset all the time. We saw these originally throughout the actual beta. And then you have your major challenge, which is unlocking the DedSec faction. It takes a total of 700,000 experience points, which sounds like a lot, but in reality, it's not going to take that long. Now, if you really wanted to, yet again, another way to spend money, you can use those X coins and unlock it for 1,000 coins if that's something that you really, really want to do. And speaking of those X coins, there's a couple of different founder packs that you can get. Each founder pack comes with limited edition skins, as well as X coins that you're able to utilize for other things within the shop. And of course, as you would expect, the shop works perfectly fine. And yeah, if you thought the pricing with the Call of Duty shop was a little crazy, it's a lot worse here. We're talking like $30+ in order to get a bundle that only features 4 fucking items. You're out of your mind, XDefiant. What is wrong with you? Go back and reevaluate this. I understand that XDefiant is a free-to-play game. I totally get it, and we're thankful for that. But the prices of these bundles are just not it, especially the daily items. These prices are just not it. Please reevaluate these. The Battle Pass, on the other hand, not too bad of a value. For 700 coins, that's around $7, you actually get access to 50 different items. Some of these items include weapon XP boosters, Battle Pass XP boosters. You get X coins back in return. So, yeah, at the end of it all, if you buy one Battle Pass, you actually can get the next battle pass with the amount of coins that you get in this first battle pass. So if you're never buying bundles, all you gotta do is buy it once and you'll be good to go for the rest of this game's life if they continue doing it this way. But there are some pretty impressive looking skins along the way, and for $7, you can't really beat it if you're just playing the game and you're earning all these along the way. I really like the legendary MDR skin called Firestorm that you end up getting at the end. Of course, just like every other game in existence, there are free items that you can get without spending the $7, but to get all 50 items, you are required to spend that money. There's also a Battle Pass upgrade, which gives you the premium Battle Pass and 12 tier skips. I don't know why anyone would want to do that though. This thing is going to be going on for 42 days. There's only 50 tiers. So I would assume people are going to run through this rather quickly. And by the end of it, especially with all the XP boosters you get along the way, you're going to be sitting there twiddling your thumbs working on your bronze, silver, and gold camos. So once again, I just need to reiterate, this is the preseason because it should be more here. I remember talking to the devs about camouflage patterns and working on camo challenges and working on like barracks challenges and the like, and none of that seems to exist as of right now. So I don't know if that's officially going to be showing up in season one, the official season one. But yeah, it's just a little confusing to me. I will say I'm really happy that a lot of the bugs and glitches that many of us were experiencing back during the beta have been fixed, like the HUD glitch, where you couldn't actually size your HUD properly. Thankfully, that has been fixed, so we can now do that. I'm also a big fan of the overall gameplay. From the matches that I've actually been able to play today, things feel pretty good. I'm happy about that. You know, changing up the settings, how they work for you, and playing on a controller, it's going to feel a little bit different to other first-person shooter games like Call of Duty. It's not going to feel as smooth as a game like that, but it's better than what it was originally, in my opinion. It doesn't feel as floaty either, but that kind of goes against something that I noticed with the sliding. The sliding feels like super clunky. I don't know if they made a change to it, but I feel like I can't get back into the fight fast after sliding. It's like now penalizing you for choosing to do that, sliding around corners or sliding into a fight. I don't know how to feel about that. It definitely feels off to me. Let me know what y'all think in the comment section below. It's almost like there's a little bit of a delay when you go to slide and then get back into the fight. It's really weird. Like, I don't remember it feeling like that. Otherwise, everything else feels pretty good. The jumping almost feels accelerated in a way, which is a little weird. The floatiness that I complained about before, it doesn't really feel as floaty as it used to. But that's pretty much all I can say right now about XDefiant preseason. I just feel like the launch is not as it should be, personally. I guess in my brain, I was totally expecting it to be completely different. I thought that there was going to be character challenges that we could do to unlock new character skins. I thought there would be weapon challenges that we could do to unlock weapon camouflage patterns. I thought that there was going to be more challenges in general, like a barracks menu where we can unlock unique calling cards and ways to thumbs up, you know, different players in the game with the emojis and things like that, and character backgrounds and all that different stuff. But we're literally playing the beta, just a locked off version of the beta, and we're re-unlocking everything that we had in the beta. So I don't really understand. I don't get it. To me personally, this is a rough launch. This is not at all what I expected to see. I don't think saying preseason gives it a pass in any way, shape, or form, especially when you consider the amount of delays that this game got. And I'm sure that there are a lot of things cooking in the pipeline, but I am incredibly worried about the future of this game, because what we are effectively playing is the same beta for 42 days until season 1. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. That is all I gotta say in this video for now. I'm gonna continue to play XDefiant. I'm going to continue to unlock the attachments for the weapons that I want to use. I'm definitely gonna be trying to get level 100 on a couple of these weapons to get the gold camo, because it does look pretty good. It looks nice and shiny. I'm happy about that, but I guess I'm just like, I don't know. I was expecting something different. I was expecting there to be a little bit more flourish. I was expecting there to be a little bit more competition and maybe more game modes and maybe a little bit more, you know, maps coming through. But unfortunately, we don't have that currently. I've seen some data miners that have stated that there are other things coming through, but at this point, I don't know if they're unlockable things or if they're just going to be parts of bundles and battle passes. Leave your thoughts in the comment section below. Thank you guys so much for watching this video here today. If you enjoyed, drop a like, subscribe for more, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.